All right, you are getting ready to write your first ACE response for your English class this year. Last year, you wrote several ACE responses. You did it in English class, and you also did it for your world history class. This is a great way to make sure that you're analyzing things appropriately. So, you are going to be analyzing the theme From the Wasteland by Alan Paton. The basic requirements that you answer the question with a literary argument provided by using the ACE response and focusing on the theme. You must provide at least one piece of evidence, a quotation from the text that supports the theme. You're going to cite your quotation using MLA format. Notice this is an example of MLA format. Whenever you start to type yours, come back up here and check this. Make sure that you do not have a period inside your quotation marks. The period is on the outside. You do not have the word page written here. You just have the author's name here. The only time there would be anything inside this quotation mark, and only time there'd be punctuation here, is if it was an exclamation point or a question mark. If that's the case, if it was an exclamation point, it would look like this, and then a period at the end. If there was a question mark there, it would look like this, with the period still at the end. But if this was just a sentence, a storm must have brought it here, period, and that's what was in the text, then you'd take the period and you put it at the end. You're also going to be providing a clear explanation of how the evidence or the quotation supports and connects to the theme. So your question is, what is the theme of The Wasteland by Alan Paton? So consider the theme sentence starters that we have given you. You're going to circle the one or highlight the one that you think fits the short story best. You must add on to this sentence starter in order to create the theme. This is a starter. This is not an entire theme. You must add on. So when it comes to war, there are no winners because people make choices and choices make people. So hope and fear drive human behavior, causing place and culture impact perception and perspective because or causing with the outcome of. You need to add on to these. So pick one and develop your theme for The Wasteland. So now that you have your theme together, you're going to start on the A part of your ACE. This is the answer, the argument. Here you are formulating an answer or argument based on the central question. This is sort of like your thesis statement for your thesis statement or topic statement for this paragraph. It must be specific, narrow, and significant. You need to be able to support it with evidence from the text. So here is a sentence starter to get you going. Ready? The Wasteland by Alan Paton is about, and then I want you to put your subject word here, is about injustice, is about friendship, is about family, is about choices, is about war, is about human behavior, is about culture. Pick a subject word. Then provide a three-sentence summary. Tell me three sentences, what was this mostly about? So if it was about choices, then three boys made a choice. What was that choice? Where did that choice lead them? Then finally, after you've given like a three-sentence or so summary of the story, your final sentence in this A part will say, in the short story, Patton explores the theme, and then you are going to put your theme there. Explores the theme, place and culture impact perception and perspective because blah, 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 period. You're going to write that whole thing in this box right here. This is your A box. Then you're going to move on to C. You're going to cite your evidence. So first, you have to introduce your quote so that the reader knows what's happening around this quotation, right? Otherwise, it's called a dropped quote. You can't just throw a quote out there. You need to set the scene. It should be at least two sentences setting the scene surrounding the quote you're going to use. Then you're going to lead in and cite the evidence. The man exclaimed, blah, 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 right? So again, we're not just dropping the quote in. Instead, you're going to set the scene. As the man was dashing through the wasteland, he grabbed a stick, slammed someone in the head, and exclaimed, comma, blah, blah, blah. That is what it needs to be. You have to introduce it, set the scene, and lead in. Who said it? Could have been the narrator that said it. It could have been a boy that said it, or it could have been the man that said it, but it has got to be somebody said it. You're going to put all of that right here, and you're going to make sure that you use proper MLA format. Then you're going on to the E section, the explain section. Explain how your piece of evidence supports your argument. This is your because statement. So here's a sentence to get you started. This action that the man did, this exclamation the man made, this statement supports the idea of the theme. And then you're going to put your theme in again. Because, and you're going to tell me why. Give me three or four sentences here. This is the analysis. This is where you are breaking it down for us and you are letting us know that you 100% understand why your quotation supports your theme. This is analyzing. Finally, you're going to conclude. You're going to write a final sentence to summarize your thoughts, wrap up the paragraph. It should relate back to your A from the beginning of the paragraph. After you have all of these boxes filled in, your A, C, E, and your conclusion sentence, you are going to put your ACE response into paragraph form. This outline is already in order, so all you're going to have to do is copy and paste. We have the spot for that right here. We want your final paragraph to be typed right here. So go up to the A, copy the A, paste it. Go up to the C, copy it, paste it. Go to the E, copy it, paste it, and then your conclusion. Once you have the whole thing in this box, you have your whole paragraph in this box, highlight it, come up here, double space it so that we can see it clearly. Make sure it's not bolded. Make sure it's in Times New Roman. Okay? So now you have your ACE response in paragraph form. You've indented because a paragraph starts indented. You're going to make sure that you've used your specific details, that you have spell checked and grammar checked. If you have Grammarly on your computer, that's a good idea. You have to have, at the absolute least, 8 sentences. If you have followed this outline, you have, at the very least, 8 sentences. Your answers can be longer if you're providing more detail. If you need to add some transitions, then I encourage you to do that. Maybe you need to connect some of these parts together. Double check your MLA format for your evidence. You're completing academic writing. There's a few things you need to remember, and that is you cannot use dead words. You learned these last year. Dead words are words like that, things, a lot, it, stuff. I want you to go through your paper right now and look for those words. When you see them, replace them. Take them out. If it's it, tell me what it is. If it's things, tell me what the things are. You cannot use personal pronouns. I, we, us, you. If you have those in there, you need to change your writing. You need to change it to one, society, people. Make sure all of your sentences are complete sentences. Capitalize proper nouns and the beginning of sentences. Again, spell check. Write in the present tense. And then I want you to highlight it and listen to it. So those of you that downloaded the speech to text, like I told you to, or text to speech, you can just highlight it and click the little megaphone at the top and it will read it to you. Once you've done that, this video right here will assist you in editing one last time, because it's important to edit more than once. So here is a video, and when you click on this, it will take you through editing an ACE response. So I encourage you to watch this to make sure that you have things done properly. Once you have done all of these things, you are free to submit this assignment.